Welcome to another episode of Don't Trust the Trustee, on the web at www.don'ttrustthetrustee.com. It was early morning, about 4 a.m., when George walks into the living room, where his older sister Geeta was sitting on a couch. Hi, sis. What are you doing?
Hi, brother. Just reading the Bible. God is so great.
It's good to see you so connected with God. You have always inspired me. I've always trusted you and looked up to you. I just checked on Mom. She was in pain. I gave her some medicine. She's resting now.
Well, George, the doctors are not giving her much time. Any time now. This cancer has taken a toll on her.
That's for sure. I wanted to talk to you about the trust. I trust you fully and always have. With my background problems with the law, it is best you acted as the trustee. And you know, our little sister Dee Dee is in no shape mentally to do any of this.
Yes, of course, George. You can always trust me.
Okay, Geeta. How about the properties? There are four of them. How about you and I sell the two together and we'll split the money down the middle? As far as for Dee Dee, we should give her the duplex as Mom wanted. That way, she can live in one and rent the other. You know how she is. At least this way, she'll have a roof over her head until she dies, and that's what's important to us. Geeta, right now, as you know, Dee Dee lives in a bad-shaped mobile home. Needs a lot of repair. It is unhealthy.
Yes, George, I agree. I was talking to my husband, Rain, about this, and he agrees. I am so glad I have a great and an honest husband.
Yes, Geeta, I trust your husband, Rain, like a brother. Folks, here's a quick scenario. Geeta is the eldest child in the family. George and Geeta have been close to each other all their lives. Geeta and her husband are well-to-do. Geeta has always represented herself as a holy person, but things are not always the way they appear. Geeta and George have a younger sister, Dee Dee. Dee Dee has been involved with drugs in the past. She lives in a rundown mobile home at a trailer park that her mom and brother purchased for her. Their mother, Malif, had insisted that Dee Dee should inherit the duplex. Malif had stage 4 cancer, and there wasn't much time for her on this earth. George, along with his wife Ole, has been taking care of her for 3 years since he lived close to her. Geeta and her husband Rain lived far away, and once in a while they'll come to check on her. Geeta and Rain purchased a new house in Northern California. They were too busy to help George out. Geeta had stated to George that she was busy remodeling the model home they just bought. Was that boastful by a holy woman? But George didn't think much of it. Early Monday morning, Malik was laying on her bed, raising her hands up and down as if she's talking to someone. Mom, who are you talking to? George wakes up, his wife worried. Ole, wake up! Mom is talking to someone and there's no one there. Weird.
Okay, don't worry. I'll go make us some coffee.
Well, folks, Ole went to the kitchen to make coffee. George went to the bathroom to brush his teeth. When he came back, his mom Malif was not responding. He screams to Ole. Ole, hurry! I think Mom just died. Geeta, Mom is dead!
Okay, don't let them take the body away. We are on our way.
George calls his daughter Raquel to come help. Raquel has been helping him for years with Malik, her grandmother. Raquel, Grandma is gone. She just died.
Okay, Dad. I am on my way.
Well, folks, there you have it. Malif is dead, and Geeta is now in charge. She and her husband arrived late Monday afternoon. They had Malif's body taken from the house. Malif had instructed Geeta to have her friends attend a memorial at a specific restaurant, but Geeta and her husband decided it is too expensive, so they had it somewhere else, even though her mother left her more than enough money for it. George was puzzled. This is not like them. He asked himself, why are they behaving like that? A few days went by, and George visited Geeta and Rain at his mom's house to check on things. Hey Rain, have you contacted a real estate agent yet?
Hey George, I only have one thing to say to you. Your sister and I are in charge. Don't you dare interfere. We decide what happens, how it happens, and with whom it happens.
Rain, are you being serious? What's with this attitude?
George, I never liked you. Don't make me angry, or you'll regret it.
You see, folks, the cards have turned. Rain's true colors are coming out. He was always nice to George, but now, since he is about to inherit a lot of money, and Malif is no longer around, he changed. It seemed that throughout the years, he was nice to the family knowing that one day, he and Geeta will inherit a lot of money. George went in to question his sister Geeta about her husband's attitude. Hey Geeta, what's up with Rain? He told me not to interfere. What's up with that? I thought we were going to work together. Also, You are the trustee, and not him.
Yep, I am the trustee, and don't you forget it. Mom put me in charge because she trusted me.
Geeta, that is not true. You and I decided on that. Why are you acting this way?
We never agreed on that. Mom trusted me and put me in charge, not you.
Geeta, how about your poor sister Dee Dee? Are you going to allow her to move to the duplex?
Nope. I will continue to pay her monthly rent at the mobile park. She can stay at the trailer park. She deserves nothing.
Geeta, Mom's will states that she moves there. What are you doing?
George, Dee Dee doesn't deserve anything. Don't you get it? You need to go before you make me angry.
Well, folks, it is amazing how things change so fast. Geeta and Rain were always nice to George, and now they are denying him everything and not following through with the living trust that their mom had prepared. You see, folks, those close to you can be very deceitful for the love of money. All I can tell you is, do not trust the trustee.
George, I don't have any food. I am hungry, and Geeta doesn't send me any money. I don't know why she is acting like that. It is sad. I have called her many times, and she does not answer the phone. Mom wanted me taken care of. I am an extremely sick woman, as you know. I need help.
Geeta, you need to send your sister money. She has no money for food. You are collecting over $3,000 per month renting the duplex. Send her some money, please.
George, if you're that concerned, why don't you give her the money?
I am so sorry about that, but here is some money to help you out. I'll talk to the lawyer and see what we can do. As you know, Dee Dee, to take a case to court could take years, and they know that.
I know that, George. It'll take years to get to court. I think they want me dead so their kids can inherit the property. I feel it.
No, Dee Dee, don't say that. We'll try to work it out. Well, folks, as you can imagine, a poor girl's devastated. Here, she was left with an inheritance that the trustee felt she wasn't deserving of. How sad. Because of her broken heart, they found Dee Dee dead 10 months later in her mobile home. The coroner's office could not determine the cause of death. Folks, listen and listen to me carefully. Don't trust the trustee. There is much more to this sad story, but I want you to know that if you have a living trust in place, hire a reputable firm to act as your trustee. Visit don'ttrustthetrustee.com for more details. Money is the root of all evil. There are many families that turn against each other because of an inheritance. If you enjoyed this episode, wait till you see the next one. If you or someone you know have a similar story, please let us know. Tell us your story. Click on Report Your Story on the web, www.don'ttrustthetrustee.com, and you might be our next featured episode.